Recording of the Executive Board Meeting, 5th District Georgia State Nurses Association, held on November the 17th, St. Joseph's Infirmary.
I believe we have a forum. I certainly appreciate so many of you coming out, particularly the new members of our board. We want to welcome all of you. I wonder, before we get started, is there, would you offer a word of prayer?
Gracious Heavenly Father, as we gather here tonight, guide us in the right direction and show us the way. We ask in our name. Amen.
I don't know if all of you know Mrs. Alford, Allen's secretary. Would you call the roll, please?
Grateful appreciation, your kind expression of sympathy. Dear friends, your sympathy, your thoughtfulness, and the beautiful flowers will always be grateful, gratefully remembered and deeply appreciated to the family. The family of Mrs. Arthur Ashton, is it Acklin, will ever hold in grateful remembrance your kindness and sympathy. It says, I am grateful to your group for your expression of sympathy. Dedication of your members is one of the greatest contributions to mankind. Many thanks, A.A. McClain. To thank you for your kind sympathy and tribute to the memory of Ethel Strubin, American Nurses Association.
You know, Ms. Strubin was at the GSNA meeting last year. General Diversity. the report of the treasurer.
They have two good ones, but better copies if you like to read them, Miss Mason.
The treasurer report of the district, the October, Rock Fulton in September, $1,536.89. Receipt, 1964 membership dues, 1965 membership dues, $958.75. American Journal Nursing, $6. Miss Market said $6.96. Total $1,139.21. Two figures together, $2,636.10. Disbursement, grant, $63.50. $363.07. Phone, $50.89. Supplies, $258. American Journal, $5. Taxes, $232.02. TS&A, $67.50. Miscellaneous, $10.30. Total, $794.86. Clearing bank, $1,881.24. Checks out, $304.06. Agrees with the bank statement, $2,185.30. The checks, I won't give the number of the checks, but one was for $67.50, one was for $226.26, and one was for $10.30. That gave the total of the $304.06. And the obligations to government, withholding tax, $44.60, Social Security, $32.82, total $75.42. State of Georgia, withholding, $1.92, total $77.34. Now the professional register, you want that? The financial report for the professional register, October 1964. Previous income balance, $1,673.24. Membership dues and benefits, $2,737.58. Total, $4,410.82. Disbursement salary, $1,502.13. Telephone service and advertising, $48.55. Rent, Hendrick Hotel, $125. Postmaster and stamps, $53. District director, $271.19. Flowers for Milton Badger, $7.73. Total, $2,767. Cleared, outstanding checks, $896.52. Disbursements for this month, $2,007.60. Total, $2,904.12. The balance in the bank was $4,410.82, less $2,904.12, leaving a balance of $1,506.70. And that $1,506.70 is the true balance for this time.
This is for October.
This is for October. For the month of October.
What is your pay?
we have a report of the executive secretary at this time?
I have given you a mimeograph report. Some of them are a little vague, they haven't ran out of ink, but we are up to date in the office, and bookkeeping and filing up to date, all the statements have been out. And you know, Fab, we do have 108 1965 members who have renewed at this time with three associates.
Thank you, Karen. Ms. Hammond isn't here. Is there a report program?
May I tell them about the film they're going to show? This is one that was picked out to represent America in the International Festival. It was shown in Scandinavia, and it has to do on communication. We first saw it at the Executive Secretary's Conference in July, and it was booked on up through Christmas, but the distributors were kind enough to let us have that copy. It'll be a 14-minute animated, and it's a good one on communications. At this time, we're using it during the week throughout the hospital and other clinics. In addition to that, I believe Ms. Garland, you have an announcement about another film as a major treat for them on the program.
Yes, we're going to have a little pet talk about a tour to Honolulu. The film, a door prize, what have you.
Is this a Christmas?
No, this is Thursday.
Oh, come in. Just not going to have the demo, as far as I know. Everybody's booked up, and there's been no report on that. Time is running short, and they say we've had enough at the medical academy this year, and business was more important, but you just pass it up. I hope that's agreeable with the group.
Do you have anything on printing?
No, well, we had the 1,500 copies of the meter. And then, of course, we had our different supply envelopes, which are absolutely wonderful. And particularly now that we have new posts on that, and we have our own post box and distributed to other divisions. That's all the things we've done.
Thank you, Karen.
Thank you.
Ms. Hammond, is here on that proposed change to the bylaws. I ask that the State Association of the Parliamentarians and the Chairman of the Bylaws give us in writing the procedure for changing bylaws. It seems that we run into more difficulty getting even one word changed. So after many, many conversations, different people, long distance phone calls, back and forth, if there's one word changed in this, it'll take us a year to get it. One word change is bylaws. So, remember, this Lafayette Committee has been a little busy carrying on all this communication. Do all of you have a copy of the meeting with the changes?
Madam President, I hardly know where to start on this. I think my simplicity or my efforts towards simplicity have caused some complications, particularly since I was involved in two other meetings this afternoon and I picked up some things at the office and I think I've come off with the wrong thing, but I'll do my best to present it to you in some kind of instructive form. You have copies of the old bylaws with the proposed changes that were presented to you at the last term of the meeting.
It's all printed in the meter except this from the model form, just one that has to conform, disciplinary action here. All of it was printed in the meter. They did not have this Ms. Watt in giving us her changes from the board. This is the only thing left out.
In an effort to help you get some degree of continuity, some sense out of this, the only way I could do it was to do up some copies for you tonight with the bylaws as we are proposing them, or as we did propose them, and we wrote to the state bylaws committee, sending you copies of our proposal, the ones that we presented to the board at the last meeting, and asked that we be allowed to make editorial changes, because we did not have the time to go through before the last time where it said executive board changes to board of directors. And if I looked, I read these things until I was cockeyed the other afternoon, and in spite of that, my secretary picked up two places today, yesterday, where I had failed to make that change, and so I hope that we've gotten them all.
But let me tell them one thing you did. You picked up an error that we had 2 years ago. It was printed in the meter, and it was passed and all, and it was a typographical error. And we thought it was kind of a few cents in George State News. And we had read the thing 6 times. So
you can read them 6 times and still pick up little things, I'm sure. But I did make an effort in this mimeographed copy that you have, to make all of the editorial changes and to include in it the recommendations that we got from the state, the DSMA bylaws committee, which I think I should read to you, and then you would understand there's only one thing that I think we have not taken care of, and I didn't know how to do that.
Would you like her original copy if it's better than what
the state? No, I can read it, all right. They state that Article 3, which was entitled Membership, and it's now entitled Members and Associates. This was a recommendation from the state committee on bylaws. So they suggested that we should make that Members and Associates, and we took care of that. They said that our Article 3, Section 3D, should be a separate article. This is on the disciplinary action and rights of members and associates, and suggested that we read this ANA model phone. That this should be a separate article, which would be our Article 4. And this would then require renumbering all articles, renumber Article 4 through Article 19. Which would make it Articles 5 through 20. And we tried to took this into consideration in this. So they are renumbered. We made a separate article, Article 4, out of the disciplinary action and rights of members and associates in accordance with the standard form and in accordance with the recommendations from the state bylaws committee. And then renumbered all of the subject articles. Article 8, our new number 9, old Article 8, which you're looking at the meter, obviously look on the new one, Article 9, Section 1, the recommendation from the state committee recommends that the chairman of the registry committee be an ex officio member of the board of directors without vote. Having an official registry really necessitates the chairman to present the problems and reports to the board in person. So in new Article 9, in Article 9 in the multi-list copy that you have, you notice that in Section 1 we did incorporate this, that by stating that the officers and chairman of all the intersections of the 5th District of the Georgia State Nurses Association shall constitute the board of directors of this association. The chairman of the registry committee shall be an ex officio member of the board without vote. Then Article 13. Article 12, meetings, entire meetings, Section 5, they suggested, our state committee suggested that we substitute the word business for the word exercise, which we did in Section 5 of Article 13.
the order of business rather than the order of exercise. Suggestion was incorporated in our edited copy. And then M, in the old order of business, if you're eliminating the first level of membership on an alumni basis, then you should delete the words "and alumni associations." I think we had asked for a report under M in the order of business old copy. We had report. No, that doesn't add up. Report of the alumni. And in O, they suggested that we delete the words "miscellaneous" or, as your unfinished or new business, should take care of any miscellaneous business. So we've made the order of business read report of sections, then L, that's K, and L, unfinished business, M, new business, and N, adjournment. And then down in the section 5, M, with annual reports of sections and annual reports of special committees, O, unfinished business, and then P, new business, and we had to renumber all the orders of business. If you remember, we presented that at the other meeting, at the last time when we presented these to you. Then Article 14, our new number 15, standing committees, Section 10. This section follows the registry manual on minimum standards. In place of A, we recommend the following, and this is what they recommended. A, the committee shall consist of at least 9 members, 1/3 of whom shall be appointed by the executive board of this district, and that should be changed to the board of directors of this district each year to serve for a period of 3 years. B, the chairman of the committee shall be a registered professional private duty nurse actively engaged in nursing. C, a majority of the nurses on the committee shall be private duty nurses. The private duty nurses section shall be asked to submit a list of private duty nurse members to the board of directors as a guide for their selection. D, the chairman of the private duty nurses section shall be appointed as a member of this committee. E, registry or district nurses association personnel shall not be appointed to serve on this committee. Beginning with D in your amendments, read letter B through F to F through J, I believe it's what it might be. So this meant that if we incorporated their suggestions, which we did, that we would insert a new A, B, C, D, and E, as you read in your multi-list copies, and then renumber. Yes, ma'am.
Go back to that minimum standards and read that again.
Man, where are you reading from? I flipped to
Section 10. I'm sorry that I did not
number. Showing you where it is.
Section 10 of Article 15 now. On your multi-list copy, it was over Article 14.
Oh, no, I'm looking in the middle. That's what I was.
Okay.
But now this is A, B, and C.
It's included in that. See, that was corrected and sent to the meter after Ms. Watts gave it to us.
But I want you to read that part about.
Okay. Section 10, recommend that this section follow the registry manual on minimum standards. And in recommending
now that's what I'm going to ask about. Minimum standards and what? Statewide salaries and so forth? Is that what you're talking about?
I'm not talking about anything. This is recommendations from the GSMA bylaws committee, state bylaws committee. This is
When I read it before, that was a question I wanted to ask about.
Mm-hmm. But these were recommendations that were received by the committee, and this is from the committee on the state committee on bylaws.
Original copy.
And they recommend that in following, as I understood, as I interpreted this, that to follow the registry manual on minimum standards, that these would be the recommendations that would bring it to this, that would meet the standards.
Well, I just want to know what it meant, including the salaries that were charged.
She didn't explain any
of it. Well, she didn't point it out.
Because if it does, we'll say no to it right quick.
No, she didn't explain any of it.
Well, there's nothing about salaries in there.
Because
she's made the
recommendation. Because we have a statewide minimum fee.
Uh-huh.
And each district can set their own. But the minimum fee is $15, and I can tell you right now, we won't go back to $15.
No, she was trying to spell out what we originally had in there, that it'd be predominantly privacy and nurses.
When I read it, I wasn't sure what she meant.
Was trying to spell out was the makeup of the committee. Because this is all she refers to.
Right. There's no mention of salary anything. And that's not as...
Well, did you find it in your motion section?
No, I found it in the policy. These pages aren't numbered.
No, they're not.
They're not numbered.
This is not the policy. Oh, and I'm sorry. But I'm just not clear. But it's Article 15. In the motion list copy, it's now Article 15 entitled Standing Committees. And if you follow where this one starts, in the middle of that page, it's on the second page of Article 16, which involves Article 15. And then you get down to Section 10, on that second page, Section 10 of the makeup of the committee, and this is what we're referring to here. And we included their recommendations, which then meant that we had to renumber the other columns on the makeup of the registry committee. If we made, I believe it was 1, 2, 3, 5 inclusions of the 5 suggestions that they made, and they are renumbered. And then she says, wherever the words nurses professional registry are used in your bylaws, change to the words professional nurses registry. And if you noticed, I tried to do that. I may have overlooked the place. It is the nurses that are professional and not the registry. And we hardly. So we tried to make this change. And those are the only changes that the State Committee on Bylaws suggested that we make.
There's one other point.
Recommend that the bylaws state the provision for handling the dues collected from the registrars of the register. If these dues are deposited separately from the general fund, it should be stated. According to the bylaws, the district has only one depository for all funds, which must include the monies from the professional nurses register. And Madam President, I didn't know what to do with that one because I did not see that it would be up to this bylaws committee to make such a proposal, and then this would be a new proposal that would have to go entirely through channels again. And so I left this recommendation.
This is from the state.
Yes, this is signed by Ms. Watts. And this was after their review.
I asked if this that she gave us here was identical to what was published in here.
It is, to the best of my
knowledge. I'm going to say it's not, it certainly has confused us all.
No, it's identical, except that I did in this make the editorial changes, which we had not had a chance to make in this one. For instance, I changed it to professional nurses registry, and I made it when we refer to committee on functions or committee on something else, and made this consistent throughout. I also changed from executive board to this board of directors.
Well,
and I picked up the one called
exercises to business.
We made
this
every
change to the recommendations
that
Esther
Watts gave us. Every change was made as suggested in the original copy.
Exactly.
And it was mailed directly to the printer with Ms. Watts' signature. She had, wait a minute, let me show it to you. The top signature of the changes made, renumbered, and done verbatim. With one exception, she did not have the copy of the disciplinary action. She did not have her model form, and I didn't have it because I didn't know that she was going to bring it out. There was one paragraph that is not printed in your meter, and they made the word forum here, which should be form. This is taken verbatim from your model form. Otherwise, every correction that Ms. Watts suggested made were printed in your meter. She did not have one paragraph here, and we have to have it. A and A makes it.
Well, she made the recommendation that we follow the model form for disciplinary action in the search data. And the only changes I made in this were editorial changes to make it read different.
Mm-hmm. Well, I would like to ask one question or two questions. First, when you go to your meetings, your convention, your fifth district, when you read that you're getting a decrease in your number of people belonging to your organization every year, and then you come up with a proposal that we will take the representation of the local alumni off of this board, how do you expect to keep your membership from decreasing?
Recommendation that came to us from the state by the state model form.
Well,
personally,
if it came,
I'm not a local alumna,
like
so
the day that it came down and from whom it came.
Because
so
I
that I could write to them directly and ask them the same question.
You also have a motion from this a member of this board that the bylaws committee seek ways and means of changing that. It was made in the district meeting.
I haven't seen them.
Well, we have one. Ms. Wells made the motion, and it was referred to the bylaws committee.
I heard a discussion at one of the meetings, but I did not hear the motion.
Well, we have it, and we have it on tape. If you'll come down to the office, I'll let you listen.
I thought you
motions. You weren't there. We do. We type them, but we tape them, too. We have every meeting that we've had since we've had this recording. And you have it verbatim, except one. I forgot to plug it
we
in.
We got a tape recorder at home too, but we erase anything.
Well, we nothing has nothing.
So
has
you don't tell me what state and what isn't state.
Well, if you'd like to hear,
I
you'd like
have,
to read it
I'd
in
like
your minutes.
To see them, yeah.
Well, it's in your minutes, and it was referred.
I feel like for somebody to answer my question.
It was referred. Ms. Wells made the motion that it be referred to the bylaws committee.
Mm-hmm.
That ways and means be sought. Well,
maybe we could answer her question by saying this. At the present time, the alumni presidents are members of the board, yet in the past few years, to my own knowledge, we have had a decrease in membership. Now, how do they account for that?
We had 82 new members in our alumni last year, my dear.
Are they all members of the GSMA?
No. But how am I going to talk them into joining unless they have some?
And you are here representing
we
non-members
have
132
members, most of them have years.
But I'm not a local alumna, and I feel that I'm represented through my section.
Well,
and
well,
if you have representation.
In my opinion, the majority of the 5th District nurses working here are glad to be food, and they should have.
We've got a lot of newcomers in
Atlanta. How many individual nurses do we
have? Well, you have as members, but I'm saying people working.
I'm working, and I'm
saying the majority of them. Well, you take a poll in your hospital. In your hospital.
I just think Atlanta's grown a good bit, and we have a lot of newcomers into the area.
You must. have your alumnus and your local school represented in your organization in this district.
Well, is this a pattern over the United States? All in other states do they have it? Where the alumni president?
Would
you mean the president?
No,
I believe that we investigated it at the time, and the beginning organization was an organization of alumni over the nation, so to speak. And then with the reorganization of AMA and the new structure, the district was the first level of national membership. And I believe that's true throughout the other states at present. And I believe I was in office when we voted to have alumni presidents on the board, but with the national reorganization and the district being first level of membership, then that was reconsidered. And it was felt that the district should be the first level of national membership, and the section is subunits under the district. Now, of course, with the ANA, everybody, I guess, is studying to a certain extent the new structure and have the privilege of sending to the committee and to the biennial and final vote on any recommendations concerning the ANA structure. But I believe that is a national pattern at the moment, which was not true.
Well, I could not. Now, I'll tell you this. As president of Crop Long Alumni, and I resigned, and then they changed the day of meeting and that kind of stuff. So I'm still the president. And I could not, truthfully, tell one of the three new graduates that we've got working in our alumni. They're doing a real good job, but I could not truthfully say to these girls that you have no representation. So to me, I don't care if they're alone or not.
Well, you would have.
As far
as you encourage them,
as the alumni is concerned,
as board members,
they're going to school. They're going to school.
Miss Holland, she has the minutes, and you will sell a copy of the minutes, and they were approved if you'd like to have it read. The motion made.
You want it read? November 12th, 1963. Says it was moved that the bylaws committee study the board representation, namely alumni representation on the board, now that the alumni is no longer the first unit of national membership. The motion was by Ms. Wells and Ms. English. Carried.
But when we had our voting, you went. You had a purpose to go.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
But now they don't feel there's a purpose.
So they don't go.
I'm afraid I was in my
heart. The reason I went was to come back and tell other nurses at Crawford Long what went on, what we voted on, and what happened.
That's right.
And I attended everything.
The other thing that I remember very definitely, and I didn't approve of it, from the standpoint of the alumna, when they put in the sections, I said the alumna would go down because the nurses would not care to attend two meetings. So she'd take whichever one that inspired her the most, and she'd either go to the section she belonged to, and the alumna would go down, and we'd have that.
Mm-hmm.
But it's just something they call a progress.
I think it's been running neck to neck until in July 1962, when we voted that you let direct to your district. Well, then I've had a lot of nurses at Crawford Long that haven't paid anything since then. So last year we got out around 600 letters, most of them locally. And out of the 600 letters, we got 82 brand new members. You know, I mean, so we felt like we...
It has been a destruction.
Sure. And this is going to be the crown and blow.
Well, may I make one statement? There has been no change at any time on any of the tapes, except one corrected date. And I'll tell you that, you can't change these without somebody knowing it, because it splices right into it. You can't pick it up and leave it there to make the continuity. And that one day was when we had Nurse Nightingale service on the 12th. I looked at the calendar. It was scheduled for that date. And afterwards, I always make a comment that this is a recording of a certain date.
Mm-hmm.
And I put the recording at that date. And it's the only correction ever made. So you're at liberty anytime to come and give them.
May I say this, too? I'm also in accord with because right now at our alumni, I cannot go. I am the president also. And if a representative from the alumni, as the president or the secretary or someone from the alumni, is not a member of the executive, I don't feel in what way I can get the nurses to continue to be members of the organization. So far, there are more Grady nurses of the Grady number one that are members of this district than Grady number two. And I am afraid that next year, I'm not talking for the group, I'm talking for myself, but I'm also afraid that next year we might not have full membership or the amount that of membership that we have this year.
Well, I'm in favor of the local alumni, but has anybody got any idea what they're doing in other states? Has there been a decline in membership?
Twenty thousand decline in the last 2 years. Mm-hmm. As far as membership, it's gone from 171 to 151,000.
Well, I'm in favor of keeping along the president's on too. If we don't like it, let's just go to the meeting and vote it down.
You know what concerns me so much in this organization, that we get out here in this board meeting, we talk about all the things that these people want that are not here, and when you come to the 5th District meeting, there's nobody there.
That's it.
And the ones that are there just stirring up something all the time. I think it just looks like we're pulling the odds against people all the time. I don't want to do that.
Well, I think that's what what's the best for all, whether they're represented.
Well, I think not.
That's the way you have to do it.
Yeah, you sure do have to do that.
So we're the dozen bodies.
You have to pull for the best of the whole organization. You just can't pull for one thing. And I'm not saying that I'm pulling for the right thing. I really don't know. Sometimes I don't know. Do you really know, Terry?
Well,
that you're pulling for the right thing?
I would be pulling for more members in your nursing organization, because that's the only way you can stay up.
Right. You know what
I'm never
saying to you when you ask me to join? I don't have the money. That's the only reason I ever did. It's not because they don't have time to go to the meeting. It's not because of these other things. It's because there's so much bickering in this organization, and because there's so much pulling apart in this organization. You get a young one to tell you why she doesn't love to go to the meeting.
How would she know she isn't?
Some of them go and they don't go back.
Madam Chair, I want to say one thing. I'm not a local alumni. And we have had and there are over 400 of us here, so if the local alumni have a representation, it seems to me that we should have equal.
Well, I see no reason why they don't give you a representative.
Right.
I'm an individual and I'm represented.
Well, it would be better, in my opinion, to change the bylaws to include your non-local nurse on your board than it would be for you to get rid of your alumni association. Now, to me, that would be increasing your membership and the workable organization, because then that would get rid of your strife. And I'm not one of these kind of nurses that say that the registry has to call me first just because I'm from Crawford Long. I nurse in any hospital, in any state. I don't right now work for Susan Lubbock, but when I nurse, I will.
We have a motion to accept the report of the nominating committee. Are you ready to vote? We'll go to the body Thursday afternoon, so I vote for them to share.
Now, we're voting.
To accept the report of the nominating committee.
As it's written and leaving out the alumni.
This proposal.
Now, there's one more question. I thought we always met at 7:30 in November. How come that doesn't?
You were not at the last meeting, Ms. Hall. You're a little bit behind time. They said it at 4:30. Usually you have your bylaws presented at your annual meeting at a 4:30 meeting. But because ANA did not send out the model form in time for anyone to have bylaws in readiness for the committee to approve it, they had not been approved by the executive board, so they had to be presented to the executive board, which they were at our last meeting, and you were not there. So it was voted to have the meeting at 4:30 in order for everyone to go to the meeting.
Well, now you're going to leave out the occupational health nurse. If you're going to have representation through your section,
there will never be a time that you could get everybody.
Well, I know it,
but
that's the whole section.
Then you should have been at the meeting last time, then voted down, because it was voted to have it at 4:30.
The last time it met, I had resigned.
Well, we didn't know about it. You should have sent that to us. We didn't know. That's the trouble. The alumni don't send us reports, and we don't know. We haven't got the report from the alumni.
You got your report, ma'am, my officers. You should have.
I have had no resignation of your resignation, or I wouldn't have sent you a card if I'd known you'd resigned.
No, I said it.
You
reinstated
it?
Yeah. But you've got yours, because it's been mailed with the new officers and chairman of all committees.
But at any rate, you were not at the meeting, and it was decided, discussed in regards to having a dental meeting and the business. But the bylaw was more important, so that it was decision that they had it at 4:30 and it be announced in the meeting. And we tried to do it.
Well, I just had quite a few occupational health nurses to call and wonder why it's been changed. And I said, well, it's like me. I didn't know, but I'll find out.
For 6 years, you've had the November meeting in the form of a friendship dinner, but the business was more important, so that's why I was changed.
You can't, there's nothing, this group cannot change the committee report. The report has been made.
You'll have to accept it and go on.
The report has been received. It's not been approved. It's not been adopted. It's received. So therefore, it goes to the district meeting. And if we don't like what's in it, we vote against it.
I think it's a mistake,
because it's real hard to interest people in something when they do not have representation. Very hard.
The same way with the students.
But if the majority of wills is that way, well, I'm certain to go along with the back of the room.
But frankly, I agree with Ms. Mason, with Ms. Holland. Ms. Mace was talking about, she was talking about the registration of the convention.
Mm-hmm.
What she was talking about.
Yeah, I know what she's talking about.
Only 237 people attended that convention. And I have known the time when there was 500 or 600 people going to those conventions.
And I have said it.
And
we had 600 and something that was held in Atlanta a few years ago.
Yes, that's right.
Mm-hmm.
And it's really something else.
All the hospitals have made that convention a wonderful convention. And it's really handled by the young nurses.
It's
wonderful. And it's, if I remember right, 600, a little over 600 people. And they were not all Atlanta people. They were all over the state. We all got.
It doesn't make a difference to me, and I'm not speaking from a personal standpoint, but I am speaking from the standpoint of the alumni being represented. It's equivalent to taking the district presidents off our state GSNA board. And if you take our district presidents off our GSNA board, you'd see things hit the bottom in a minute. I've always, now AMA, I've been in this business a long time, and I know what has gone before. Now, ANA has almost fought the Georgia because we have kept our district presidents on that board. And I have contended, and I shall contend as long as I can talk, that the district presidents should be on that board. Else, how will they know what their organization's doing? And I wouldn't be in favor of paying a dime to the organization if the district presidents are taking on that board.
Way to get information back to the grassroots.
That's what I'm talking about. That's exactly what I'm talking about. And we have good attendance at those boards. Every district is always represented. They can go back and make the report and contact. And it's the same thing in the line. Now, if you take the district presidents off, why, that's what you're going to be up against. But of course, as I said a while ago, if the majority wills it, I'll abide by it, but I think you see.
Well, that goes back to what the old Boston Tea Party, doesn't it?
Yeah. Taxation.
Without representation.
It does, in the states that have voted the presidents off the state board feel that they have representation through the sections, isn't that right?
They've never had it. Georgia's about the only state. They do not have. Now, wait a minute. No. Now, let's get our lines clear. Section representative on the state nurses board, GSNA board, does not give district representation because there are 15 or 16 districts and there's only 6 sections. Now, that's not adequate.
Uh-uh.
But
this is the thinking in the states that have done this.
I don't know what their thinking is, but Georgia's about the only state that has always, and we've had that ever since I can ever remember, and I shall always hope that we will always have district representation on our GSNA board. And now the ANA does not say you've got to do this.
No, that's right.
They just offer it as a suggestion, and you can do it if you want to. You can do whatever you want to, because after all, we certainly have some rights and privileges as a district association. And I would never be in favor of the district president.
Well, I sat on the phone with Tim last night.
But
May I say that I think Ms.
Boston Field certainly deserves a great deal of credit going to much
work
trouble, and the efforts of our secretary are certainly appreciated, because this was a big detail.
We have a vote to accept the report of the committee.
To receive it.
To receive it.
You can't do it. You cannot change the committee report.
That's right.
The board cannot. They can offer suggestions, but they can't change it.
Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary, no. We'll see you Thursday.
We have no report from her.
Well, I have something I'd like to bring up from myself a little bit if you've got time. You got time?
We'll take time, sir.
I have a copy here of the, I guess most of the nurses have received these copies from the from ATW on the administration of the Nurse Training Act of 1964. And I'd like to you don't want me to go in then into this and tell you what that law provides, do you, all the way through? Do you put it rather brief. I can cover it in a few minutes if you want to hear it.
Then you want to hear it.
I'd like to advise it on y'all.
Well, the act provides for construction grants in the that is to collegiate, associate degree, and diploma schools. And to the collegiate program, $35 million is allocated. And $55 million is allocated for the associate degree and diploma schools of nursing. And that is construction grants to cover the cost of building. And then there are project grants, which covers the cost of improving the program in these in the three types of schools. And $17 million. It has been appropriated for the purpose of improving programs, that is adding teaching material and faculty and what have you, if you can justify it. Then, number three, there's a partial reimbursement to the diploma school resulting from an increased enrollment, which they anticipate will come about as a result of this act. $41 million has been set aside for that. Now, this is the part that gives me a great deal of concern. Traineeships for advanced training of professional nurses are available to prepare teachers, administrators, and supervisors. The traineeships are available for preparation to serve in other professional nursing or other professional nursing specialties determined by the Surgeon General. And $50 million is allocated for this program. Now, $50 million is a lot of money, and we need a lot of teachers in our schools of nursing. Now, I was told today that they're considering, I don't believe there's not been any real definite rules and regulations on this act circulated yet,
but in the process of considering right at the present time the policies which in effect become the law of administering this act. And I would like to recommend, I'd like to move that this board, I write that motion out for you if you want to see it in a minute, but I want to say it first. I want to see if it makes sense. I'd like to move that this board recommend to the National Advisory Committee to the Division of Nursing, I put all that out in the motion, USPHS, Department of Health, Education, and Welfare, that these traineeships be made available to all graduate registered nurses who wish to continue their education from after they've gotten their RN and they want to go on and get their degree, then I'd like to recommend to this body, it's the National Advisory Committee that acts on this, and I'd like for this board to go on record as recommending that these traineeships be provided to all graduate registered nurses who wish to go into teaching positions and administrators and supervisors and so on. So I write the motion. Now,
that's second.
You don't need to wait on that if you want to go ahead. I think I made my motion clear. If anybody has any discussion on it, there's discussion. If they don't like it, then let them say so now.
That's a good idea. I'll speak on.
I wish you'd say it again if you don't mind. I know what you're saying, but
Board of Directors of the 5th District recommend to the National Advisory Committee that the traineeship for advanced training on professional nurses be given to all graduate registered nurses. What they're considering, as I understand it, is that they get it only in the last year. Well, now there's about 2.5 years here that if you go down to the medical college, or I don't know what they do at Emory, but I know that one of my students has just gone to the medical college and she's got to go back and repeat all the courses she had down here at Georgia State because they don't give credit. And so that means she's going to have to spend about 2.5 or 3 years in college before she gets her degree. And if these traineeships are given only to the nurses who are in the last year of attaining that degree, then there's a lot I'm not doing.
That's right.
That's the baccalaureate. Yeah. The last year of the baccalaureate.
Yes.
It's not graduate work.
No, no.
That's the way
the federal traineeships were now. Well, but I didn't know that this new nursing training act was the same one.
Well,
they're considering it. They have not yet
set
upon the policy. But they're considering it, making it just the same thing. And so, I just thought we got a word up there. Airmail special delivery to the National Advisory Committee that the board of the 5th District Georgia State Nurses Association of 1,100 and some members wish to recommend that these traineeships be made available to all graduate registered nurses because we need teachers in Georgia. Now, some of the other states may have, but we don't have them here.
Can Ms. Hudson give us a letter and have that in detail and let us send it?
Yeah, I'm going to write the motion now, and then, so you can go ahead if they feel that I'm demanding enough, and then I'll... finish writing, because if you're going to use this as a body of the letter, part of the letter, it needs to be written.
Do you understand the motion?
Yes.
Are you ready to vote?
Yes.
Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary, no. Motion is carried. Amen.
We have $6 million sitting up there, then I won't be afraid the nurses pay it.
All of
the interest.
All of it.
Yeah, we didn't say it's an outright grant. This is. Now, they do have the loan funds down here for the students present currently in the School of Nursing, not to exceed $1,000 per year. And then they have a forgiveness clause in that. They forgive them 50% of it if they work a year. For every year they work, they get 50% forgiveness.
Well, didn't that, in our last election, did our educational programs all pass? Amendments 2, 3, 4, and 5, didn't they all pass?
It's not beneficially announced yet because all the complete returns are not yet in from all the counties. It's only in from a little over 100 counties, and there are 159 counties, so it's not all in, but there's enough of a margin that we feel sure that we'll get the counties already reported. I'll tell you what got me so teed off on the subject. A young lady called me today, and you could hear in the distance her little baby crying. And she was trying to work on her degree. And she called me, and she wanted me to give her the information, which I've given you all here tonight, which we're just only too glad to do. But that girl is having to work, make up these 2 years between her graduation, 2.5 years, or a year and a half, between her graduation and the time she can get control money for her traineeship. And I just felt that she ought to have that money. And you see her struggling to get a degree, which is certainly commendable, but when you can hear that little child crying in the distance and thinking that she ought to be able to get this money, well, I just felt like we ought to do something about it. Sit around.
Well, that's
all I had in mind. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Hurst. And we'll move on to our other report. Atkins included the membership report and her written report. Do you have any public relations that was included?
We didn't release, well, I didn't put in there, we had one release in the data papers.
Is there a report on the career committee for Ms. Mallory? No, the committee on professional practice. Insurance.
For the benefit of those that were not there, we won the award for the best percentage insurance-wise,
mm-hmm.
in spite of the fact that our chairman had moved to New York and said she had sent us the resignation, but we didn't know it. We'd been unable to contact her. Until she got ready to transfer membership, we didn't know where she was until we sent a statement to renew.
But we won the bond. Study committee of the registry. Madam President, may I ask a question before I give you the question? My question is this. Do we have a list of names submitted tonight to appoint the registry committee?
absolutely necessary, because Sister Christine and I have stayed in this capacity longer than what we thought was going that had been required of us. And due to the fact that we do not have a registered committee that would be able to function and get recommendations to the board to be voted on yet this year to start out for the beginning of the year, I have two recommendations. And then Sister Christine and I bow out.
Well, we are going to try to set up our committee after the district meeting starts tonight.
Or on the next board meeting.
That's right. That's right.
Then we will have a registered committee.
I hope so.
And, but due to the fact of not having the registered committee for them to take care of this, it's absolutely necessary we get a vote from the board on the two recommendations. And the recommendation, the first one is that the annual registered dues be $50, with the understanding that an additional amount not to exceed $10 be assessed in September if absolutely necessary in order to maintain the register for the fiscal year. But we hope with a new committee that is just the 1 year for the $50 and then to be able to drop back by trying to build up our registered membership with a new registered committee and with the help of the advisory committee. And the advisory committee has met. They did not, the next meeting, they made mention that they would like to have the new registered committee to meet with them and for all of them to get acquainted and see what they could do. Now that's just what's going to take place. That's up to them. And then the second one, that there shall be no part-time registered dues. New graduates will be extended courtesy membership until state registration is validated. This part-time, the people that pay part-time, they require as much service from the official register as the regular members. And we feel that it should not be that everybody that works through the official register should pay official register dues. And they're holding another position. They should be, even if they worked, we'll say, 2 weekends a month throughout the year, they're more than ample able to pay dues because they expect the register to place them. And that was the two recommendations.
You make a motion.
I second it.
Mr. Christian seconds. Now we're ready for a discussion. That the annual registered dues be $50 with the understanding that an additional amount not to exceed $10 be assessed in September if absolutely necessary in order to maintain the registry for the fiscal year. And that there be no part-time registered dues. New graduates will be extended courtesy membership until state registration is validated. Do you have any questions for the committee?
Well, may I ask one question and then I'll push, I promise. If on this new committee that you're going to set up, I believe I read somewhere where they were going to have the hospital
They've always supposed to have that.
All right, all right. What are they going to do about these people in the hospitals when you can't cover the patient and they let the hospital nurses cover them day after day, day after day? Now, why?
They're supposed to work that out, that's all.
Because if you're not going to have part-time. Don't misunderstand me, I'm saying I'm full of you. But,
Well, you see, part-time takes in public health, because several of those are public health nurses, you know, that pay registered mm-hmm. dues to be placed on the weekends and like mm-hmm. that. It's not only just the hospital.
I know that. I know.
So,
I'm one of them.
If they
they just have 2 weekends a month, or even 1 weekend, say, working mm-hmm. 3 nights mm-hmm. Through the year, that's 52 weeks.
Mm-hmm.
They should pay full dues because they're using the...
I agree with you wholeheartedly on that, but the only thing I say is not to let these other people work and collect
we're hoping that between the
unless you make some stipulations.
Working with the hospital people, which make up the advisor and a doctor,
yeah.
And Dr. Davis, Robert Carter Davis was the one that was asked, and he has already said that he would meet with, for the meeting, as to be at Crawford Long for this advisory committee,
mm-hmm.
And that is the meeting that Mrs. Hammack has, or Ms. Hammack, said that she would like the registered committee so they could all get appointed
uh-huh.
so that they would know who they could turn to if they needed help. And I feel having the hospital people working, they'll help solve many of these problems that have not been solved in the past.
Well, not having a bookkeeper up by, I don't blame you for getting rid of that part-time stuff, but I still say that there should be some stipulation as far as that's concerned, because you can't, if you say, like me, working at Citizen Roebuck, why, when I call the rest and says, how about me working this weekend? She says, well, you know we're supposed to pay $15 more. Well, I went and paid my $15 for you, and asked them before I got my cash. And get that over with, because I knew it was going to make 20 at less than 5, which is what it was. But anyway, got out. See, but my contention on that is, do not jeopardize your public health and your occupational health nurses for, say, the non-section, non-private duty nurses. Jeopardize one without all. So that should be hospital nurses, too.
On your question, I think this advisory committee could set up some type of policy. At St. Joseph's, we do not, unless a call cannot be filled through the registry, we don't ask a staff nurse to do it, and we only do it then because the family's begging and pleading for a nurse, and they're supposed to take that one shift, you know.
Yeah.
And we notify the registry that so-and-so, you know, our staff nurse is doing that for tonight only.
Yeah.
And I think this is a reasonable policy. I mean, they're not doing it. We beg and plead for them to fill that shift for the patient. They don't want to work, you know, that. I think I can say that for our hospital. It might be a rare exception. I mean, I think they should be controlled.
Yeah.
But we have this, only so many people putting these calls through the registry. It could be controlled very easily.
Well, you only have a certain amount that work for your hospital that is willing to do that because they have children or they have other commitments,
mm-hmm.
too. Some of them that,
I know Miss Mason, when she worked at
like
the desk, she would not give it to a staff nurse unless she could not get it filled through the registry.
Well, if you were doing any other type of nursing, you don't get it from the registry either. Don't make the difference if you do pay your people.
Well, I don't think that's fair.
Well, that's the way it works.
Mm-hmm. You
but if anybody on that register tomorrow, on my day off, I won't get a case. If they will accept you now, Miss Hooker and Brandenburger says, Holland, let me put you down because I'm liable to have to make 10 calls and everybody refuses. And I said, well, when you get tired of getting refusal, call me and I'll nurse the patient.
Well, I had a nurse tell me yesterday that's employed by Grady on the staff that she wants to work on her days off. She called one or two hospitals, and I won't say which, and not the registry, but she does not pay registry dues, and they give her cash.
And she gets all she wants.
Yes,
she
does.
Happens at a lot of them.
She sure does. And the hospital belongs to the registry, too, and I told it wasn't fair. I'm sitting right there, and that isn't right. Some kids, you do it.
Are you ready to vote on the motion from the study committee of the registry. Those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Contrary, no. Motion is carried. Report of sections, Ms. Howley, do you have one from the administration?
No, we just
haven't had a meeting yet, I suppose.
December 3rd.
EACT, Sister Elizabeth.
I'd like to state that, and I'm sorry I didn't get in, the reason why we didn't have the November meeting was the date conflicted with the convention. And we feel that we are going to have a good, we have a panel on the titles in our list here, Planning Student Experience in the Clinical Area. And so we canceled our November meeting only because of the conflicting date, and we will have the same program in January.
Exactly. Is there report for general duty? Carol, do you know?
They have a meeting at it, Piedmont, and down in the basement there, while upstairs, American Operating Room nurses were having a meeting with the doctor there, and most of the members that should have been downstairs were upstairs. They had only 9 members present, but they did elect a new chairman, Ms. Margaret Thornton. Ms. Davis has been in office during the time we've been here, and she's made a great effort to reactivate the general duty section. But Ms. Margaret Thornton from Emory is now chairman. They're hoping to have better meetings, better attendance.
Ms. Sanders,
I have one in the meeting. Mine before the name.
You haven't had anything since then. That was your annual report.
Well, I incorporated all. I was late. Did I have a quorum at the annual meeting, and so the election of office is late. But I think I also stated that at our last meeting, we voted to eliminate the December meeting, and I brought up looking for the friendship dinner, and then our next one, I think it's February.
And
we're going to have a program on the we're going to have Dr. Mine about at our friendship dinner, because we used to have a big bunch there, and on the hot month, on the heart, and what we can do in industry when somebody kills over. I think it'll be real good. So you girls are invited.
Good.
Yeah, I've already talked to
them. Good. Private duty reserves.
We had our regular meeting on October the 29th. We had a quorum present. 2 recommendations to take to the private duty section of the convention, which we did. And I'll read them to you if you want to hear them. And they were passed in the section and went on to the board to be referred to the study committee. They were that the private duty section be retained in the new structure of ANA with the chairman on the ANA board. Also that the private duty sections continue on the state and district level. And number 2 was that the private duty nurses be given recognition in the academy if one is established. And then we have a motion for new business that that the chairman appoint a committee to study and develop a nursing care guidebook for private duty nurses, which was carried, and the committee was appointed. And also we bring a motion, a recommendation to the board here that all business meetings of 5th District be held at 4:30 p.m. instead of alternate like we've been doing previously.
You have to change your bylaws on that. Mm-hmm. And we don't want to do that.
Well, I'm still bringing it. And they can go to the next year's bylaws committee, can't they?
All business meetings of 5th District be held at 4:30.
We've always had better attendance at the 4:30 meeting than they do a night meeting.
Well, What would you think of 4 o'clock instead of 4:30? That, would that be a time for the 3 o'clock nurses to get paid by 4? And it certainly would give time for the married nurses to get home and serve their families. Which is a big
idea. I'm sure we'll be glad to change it to 4 o'clock instead of 4:30.
And another thing, while you're talking about it, why don't we go ahead and we don't have it on the agenda now, but it's as good time as any to set up our meeting dates for the rest of the year. I felt like there's something I was leaving out, and I think you've reminded me of it. We usually in November decide where we're having them.
Will that mean the same, everything will be on 4:30 meetings or programs?
She's just talking about business meetings.
She said business.
In this new bylaw, there's nothing said about time. It isn't in the old either. It's just the dates, and we deleted the one in July.
It said that the time and place was decided on by the association.
Uh-huh.
So if the association decided to have it 4 o'clock, 4:30,
it's
fine, they can do it. What time does the public health get
on? We would prefer to have them in the afternoon and not have night meetings, because when they go home and have to come back, they just don't come back.
Come on. Well, I think it'd be good, because I don't like to get out at night.
Well, so many bound
nurses
have homes to get
Well, she can take it forward as a recommendation from this board to Thursday to have a vote on it.
Would
when
you
she
like
reads
to
the
resume? Do we have consensus of the board?
To do for, well, I will say it will be No, I don't think any of us ever can be making
46
at the
occupational health nurses couldn't make it. That's how many we got.
You can't come on
duty
time.
Not at no 4 o'clock last noon. Somebody lost cut the leg off. You know.
You can't get there at 4:30 either, can you?
No, that's what I say. Every other time, though, we can come. If they have it like they used to, but every other time they have it at night, we can come.
When she gives her resumes, that would be brought forward as a recommendation to the assembly.
Yes.
I'd like to make a motion, if it is agreeable with the Sister St. Joseph, that we continue our board meetings here at the Infirmary.
General meetings.
General meetings.
Well, as I was saying, we increased our membership by 82. We had 132. This is the end of the year. And we've elected our officers and all of our committees, and we've got our programs for next year. In December, we're to have a Christmas party with a covered dish supper. And in January, we're having Miss Pope to meet with the alumni. And in February, we're having a membership drive dinner.
In March, you meet monthly?
Mm-hmm, we meet monthly.
Are you?
Mm-hmm. And in March, we're having some type of an educational program that will be beneficial to both hospital and the alumni nurse. And in April, we're going to have Miss Lane meet with us. She is the director of the students, and we want her to talk with us on what we can tell the girl, the teenager down the street, how she can go in training, what she needs to know, and what not.
She
could
have been the recruitment. She wants to come.
All right, we'd like to come. But that's the main topic we'd like to talk, because so many of our older nurses as myself don't know today what it takes to run a train. I'm a good back, big heart, and in May we entertain our seniors, so we hope to have a good year.
Thank you. Is there a report from the Emory alumni? George Badges, Ms. Hudson.
We have our program set up for the year, and for our December program, we usually have a fellowship dinner and a Christmas tree. And then for January, we have one of our instructors is bringing program on clinical teaching, and then in February we have asked Dr. Malden of the Medical Association to speak to us on whatever legislation is introduced after January the 1st on Medicare. We don't know what it's going to be. But whatever it is, we'd like to have a member of the medical profession bring us the facts on. And then in May, what was the head plan there for May? Remember? I mean, April.
That's the time we entertain the seniors.
What's that?
Graduating.
Oh, yes, that's right.
And then we disband for the June, July, and August, don't we?
Yeah.
2 months, 3 months.
No, I think one meeting we have a demonstration on the new equipment.
Oh, yeah. Yes, that's right.
But I don't think I'm going to do that.
Ms. Carla Davis is to bring us a demonstration on all new equipment that she might have in the
We are extending an invitation.
We want to extend
an invitation for everybody out from every Alumia, any hospital that wants to come and hear Dr. Mullen.
Yeah. Dr. Mullen and Miss Martha Davis will be very good when she gives demonstrates the holy all this new equipment.
Grady number one, well, I believe we've had a report planned in 2 or 3 years.
We had Bernie fix them.
I know she hasn't been to the board meeting. No report. Number two, though, we've had just report. We have a report.
Well, it seems as if we all are planning for the same fair for Christmas. We are planning our Christmas party. And we're also looking forward to homecoming in August. We're working very hard towards that. And a school nurse was one of the public schools. I am trying to form a club of sponsors and teacher nursing. In order to get students interested in nursing. And there's a program also that is to be offered in the public school, the medical self-help program. And the principal has asked me to try to work with that in order to help the students to know how to help take care of themselves in case of any disaster. That all ties in with working with the alumni.
What's good? Piedmont. Has Miss Kimball been here this year?
I haven't seen her.
No report. I think that was Miss Parker.
Parker didn't give me a report, and I didn't know she wasn't coming, so I was going to ask.
Yes,
she's been coming.
And she sent us a written report too, but not for this particular meeting. It was after the needle went to Travis.
Yeah. Well,
Piedmont
has been here
under old business. We have dues for the registry, and we was there anything else besides those two recommendations? Then we have to appoint the appointment of registrars, and I have a letter of resignation from Miss Margaret Vandenberger as part-time relief registrar from Mrs. Vandenberger, effective the last of November. So why are you thinking about new people for the registrars? Maybe you take this in mind, or maybe you would like to wait until the
The bylaws state that they're appointed in November or annually. They're done, and they used to write a letter in every year asking for reappointment. But if the last time, I believe the board voted that they not be required to do that. However, it's still in the bylaws that the statement was that they not have to write a letter each year asking for reappointment. According to the bylaws, November was supposed to.
Then all we have to do is replace the Spanish and reappoint. Reappoint
those that are in office now.
Madam Chairman, I'd like to call attention to this paragraph here on section 10 in the bylaws.
The new bylaws,
in advance of the past. A majority of the nurses on the committee, registered committee, shall be private duty nurses. The private duty nurses section shall be asked to submit or enlist the private duty nurse members to the board of directors at the time of their selection. So I just thought that I would collect your attention that these bylaws are voted Thursday. And you have your appointment committee that night, then the section should come prepared with a list.
think possibly that's why we asked them for our meeting to study, and we were not given.
I wasn't even until Jekyll at 2 o'clock Wednesday. And they went in the mail that night, 6:30, as soon as I could get
The group was very disappointed and very hurt over the fact that they were not given it so they could study it and do something about it at that last meeting.
October the 1st, and I got them November the 3rd at 2 o'clock. The adjournment of the meeting at
State. Well, I just felt the section would like to have their list ready at that time because they're not going to have time to get any mail back and forth.
Now that has to do with the registered committee.
Yes.
What we're talking about now is the registrars.
Yeah. Well, I'm sorry, I thought you'd finished with that item.
No, see, we have a friend about the resignation.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Now, we can't leave it to a new registered committee in the point if you think that's wise. But it should be done in November. But if we have a meeting after the district meeting and appoint the committee and leave it to the committee to appoint the registrars, the board is supposed to do it.
Well, have you accepted this? I'm sorry, I thought you'd finished with that item of business. Have you accepted that resignation?
Well, I don't believe
we have to accept that.
I
move we accept it. Send her a letter of appreciation for her work and sorry to state that we appreciate all she's done and sorry to lose her.
Is it second?
I second.
No, I didn't.
Oh, did you?
No.
It was Nora.
Mid-Nord, excuse me. Is there discussion?
She stated she'd be back in March, and why she thought y'all ought to have a regular relief one, that any time that if you have other occasions in which you needed her, she'd be glad to help out at that time.
Well, she had been like, she's resigned before. And then we could say.
Well, those in favor of accepting the resignation, please say aye. Now, what is your wish regarding the other?
I make hope we'll keep them. They're doing all right. Doing around the yard.
Second. Question. Discussion. Those in favor, please say aye. Contrary, no. Motion is carried. We need your wishes regarding the appointment of auditors.
I move to keep the same auditors we've had. Oh, they're good. Oh, we think they're good anyhow.
They certainly are easy to get along with, if I'm saying. Cooperative.
Don't you ask me about this, man. I can tell you my own name. I had to.
Is there discussion? Those in favor, please say aye. Contrary, no. Motion is carried. Our present auditors will be retained.
Who's the counselor?
Oh, that's our lawyer.
Oh, he's legal counsel.
J. Raff McClellan.
We need to have a vote on the appointment of Mr. McClellan.
We can't have his services till next July anyhow.
He's paid up to July.
That's right.
You better keep it. Those in favor, please say aye. Contrary, no. Motion is carried. We'll retain Mr. Raff. We need at this time to appoint a chaplain. We'll hand it with our chaplain right to you.
I'm not saying this.
Oh, I won't be on this board.
Oh, second.
You may not.
Oh,
get voted back in.
Well, that's for the business meetings too, isn't it?
Yeah.
The district meetings.
Yeah, but she's done it. But she can still be.
She'll be checking.
Or she'll be checking.
But she would accept the alumni president, yeah.
Oh, sure, she could.
We have to be checking.
We have to be checking. You don't have to second them, they don't.
She's drafted.
That's right.
All in favor, Ms. Hudson, being our chaplain, say aye.
Aye.
But I'll do the best I can, I appreciate your time.
Do you have any other new business?
I'm new business, Ms. Carmen, I'd like to say something. We have a member in our organization that has done a lot for us personally and professionally. She's helped tenants of our beliefs, our work. She worked hard to keep our money coming in by having her organization 100% membership. And I believe that all of you will agree that she's a very deserving person. And I'd like to make a motion that we give life membership to this lady.
I second it, sir.
Hardly agree. We want to keep this nice way.
Workshop you had, it does, don't it have to go?
I'm retired and I'm retiring from all of this.
The board did not rule, but all the nation ruled.
You said about, and that's the truth too.
That's what you brought out in that commentary. Sure did.
You're forced to mention.
This has to go.
Is there any other business that a member would like to bring up?
Let me do that explanation of this one more time. In this section 10, the committee on the registry shall consist of at least 9 members, one-third of whom shall be appointed by the board of directors of this district each year to serve for a period of 3 years. And then dropping down here to C, it says the majority of the nurses on the committee shall be private duty nurses. The private duty nurses section shall be asked to submit at least a list of private duty nurse members to the board of directors as a guide of their selection. Now, how many will you have from the private duty section and how many would you appoint to make that the number? We were having a discussion about here and then this morning.
Well, it would
have
to be
nine.
At least 9.
Would it be 6 and 3?
9, I believe. At least 9 members, see in section 10.
You can have more, it says at least 9.
At least 9.
You
have 9 or more. Article 15, section 10.
That's for the commitment law we need at one time. It's always rotated that way.
Yes, I wonder
if we could find out how soon that we'd be able to get a list of suggested members from the private duty section. If they can't get it by the after tomorrow, like, it's a win.
They can have the executive committee and submit a list.
I suspect you have one ready, that's what you said.
No, we don't have one ready. That's why we asked for this to study it, and we wasn't allowed to have it, and it had gone on to the bulletin, and if they had let us have it then, and at our regular meeting, we could have done something.
But the executive committee couldn't.
Yeah.
Prepare it.
We can get together between now and then and see, but we felt like the whole section ought to have some right, Lois, to make suggestions too.
Everything's been off schedule ever since June, ever since Atlantic City. I think all of us ought to just try to make a resolution. We'll start the new year off right and have a good year.
I do think it was a consensus of the discussion in the meeting that most of them prefer the old method that each alumni be represented, and then with the individual group represented too, that is, they feel that that's the better method.
And the new one.
I think the private universities that crop along too the same way.
Well, the ones that discussed it at the meeting
all
expressed that that desire.
When they have enough members, when they don't include somebody from Maryland, they don't have to have just nine people, and they have enough people.
She said about the private duty section might like to know more about it rather than the executive committee picking these members. That's right.
Well, heretofore, all businesses always come to the section before voted on and let them have a preview and say whether they liked it or didn't like it. And it's always been the prerogative that they make their own pronouncement. And they were quite worked up about it, I'll tell you.
He's made way for some of these things, I guess. I knew they railroad some of, well, I'm using the word, quote, railroad, some of these things through with.
I agree with you. I don't think we all rush this thing through. Could I say something about this? Since we've waited this long, does it have to be done this week in 2 days' time? Because we've gone all year.
Well, it's been announced, and it's been, I think we'll have to do something now.
I think in order for the alumni president to take it now, I can't even get on the telephone again tomorrow night and halfway make phone calls I did last night.
Well, the members all got a copy of the meeting.
Well,
they know it's coming up. And I think you have to go through with what we've
announced. Well, from what I gather, you're going to have a good number there, because I've had more calls for directories than everybody's supposed to call 10 people, so maybe you'll have enough people there to say what they want.
I think that's a short
note. No.
Don't you, my happy. I haven't had a chance to study.
We did the best we could on those bylaws. Everybody, all of us, and Ms. Barfield has done a magnificent job on it.
I think that's good and all like that, but I think that if they couldn't get it through, it could be postponed for a year if they can't get it.
It has to be if it's not acted on. They don't have to go.
Am I incorrect? Isn't this has all come from the biennial?
Some of these proposals. Nathan and Stripps and all those that Ms. Watts gave us from the state, and had our secretary make all those copies, and that cost us $42 last time when we got together to revise them before. We had to do it Monday morning and had to have them in the office by 2 o'clock on Tuesday for the board in the state office to have them. So we had to get secretarial service. It took 9.5 hours with an assistant to get it done.
I wasn't talking about not voting on the changes of ballots. What I was speaking of, and does the registered committee have to be named Thursday night?
All committees have to, not just the register, but all the committees. We've been
named. Well, that's what I was asking for information.
We usually do this in September, but we delayed appointing our new committee until after this vote on the bylaws, the change in bylaws.
Well, I haven't had my meter 2 weeks.
Well, no, you haven't. It hasn't been asked that long.
Well, I think Christian and
bylaws, you have to know these things, don't you? Don't you have to circulate them a little ahead of time?
They know that bylaws may be adopted, amended, or repealed at any meeting by regular meeting by 2/3 vote of the members present provided in 2 weeks' notice.
Everybody was notified that they would be delayed.
But we didn't have the bylaws.
Well, we didn't either. We didn't get them until Wednesday.
Well, that's why I think why worked so hard to get them through this week then.
We did well to even get your meter in the mail, because if I hadn't seen the postmaster secretary, that probably wouldn't have even been out. We didn't get them until late Tuesday afternoon, too late to even get in the mail. And Wednesday morning, I first went to Tyson's, then we got the 1,500 meters in the post office by 10:15. The postmaster's secretary sent them through direct. Usually you wouldn't have gotten them out at all because of labor of the holiday and the weekend. So you did very well to get the lesson. We sent the immediately, as soon as Ms. Watt gave us this copy on a signature, Ms. Garland can tell you I sat there all day long waiting for these to be sent to the meeting. And even then, the printer called me about them, so we tried to get it to you as quickly as we could.
Well, it can be turned down at the meeting. The body is the membership.
Another whole year, if it says the bylaws say that it can be, they can be changed in the regular meeting.
Doesn't
Robert Rules of Order say that each member has to have these things 30 days before it's voted on?
No, we don't use Robert Rules unless they conflict.
If they conflict with the GSNA bylaws committee, we don't use them.
Well, I was
going to ask our last. That's the reason I asked for this thing in writing. The channel for this thing. It really is. We can't get it right in. It's interpreted differently by everybody.
If it says that bylaws may be announced, amended, or repealed at any annual meeting or regular meeting by 2/3, vote of the members present, provided a 2 weeks notice has been given. Now, as been stated, this has not been 2 weeks, and therefore, I know you had problems. We all realize.
It was stated in the meeting 2 months ago that they would be printed.
That they would be printed. Why cannot that section go later? When it says it can be in section 1, it can be done at regular meeting by 2/3 vote.
I think the membership having been notified to be there present Thursday to vote.
Well, he's up to that late vote for
I'll be very disappointed, but many of them have made plans, and we have tried to announce publicly and given every information we have.
Well, why find out bylaws if you don't go by them? If it says that you have to do it to the members 2 weeks before, there's no use even voting on it.
Well, what's an old bylaw? What does it say an old
bylaw? Does this mean that a 2 weeks notice has been given that this is going to happen, or that what it's going to be?
It has to be in the hands of the members 2 weeks in advance.
Well, there's no change on the bylaw on the amendment there. She just copied what we had previously. I've got
the bylaw being announced, amended, or repealed at any annual meeting or regular meeting by 2/3 votes of members present, provided the majority of the alumni. That's what's been deleted. And from opposing districts are represented and 2 weeks' notice has been given.
That's right. So we either have to go by one or the other. And we hadn't had the meter 2 weeks.
Well, Dustin, did it just say provided a notice has been given? Does it say it has to be printed in its entirety? The content?
No, stop at that stop time of the top from issue to not stop that one. That's the law. So if you want to have bylaws, you have to abide by them.
They were read as, you know, as information at the last meeting.
Yeah, the board had it.
That's right.
The board
and read to the group there as information.
But it's supposed to be given to them in writing.
And given to them in writing because it's saying,
proposing certain changes. You had the notice. Was anything published in the other meter?
Yes, ma'am. That it was published in there that they would, that they have to go to the state to be approved and then back to the executive board to be approved, and if approved, that change, in other words, we would print them in the next issue of the meter. That was in the preceding issue. And then, after they came back and they made changes on it, it was again sent back to the state. They had another meeting, and then they had to take it to the pre-convention meeting down at Jekyll. We got it November the 4th. It was utterly impossible. The printers were closed on Saturday and Sunday. They got it on Friday, and they tried to incorporate it on Monday, and they gave it to us Tuesday. There was nothing else it could be done.
It seems that in that instance that
you look at these big lines, say, if that isn't notice, I don't know what else you could do.
The burden would rest on the interpretation of the notice. And if the legal counsel should so rule, and I would certainly ask his opinion. I think it'd be a sensible thing to do is to ask his opinion. If he rules that you have sufficient notice in past meters, then the assembly can go ahead and vote on it. But if he should interpret it that you're supposed to have them in hand and read them and study them for 2 weeks, which I think is the intent of the bylaws, then, of course, we don't have them. So
let's do it. Here's the other notice.
That one size,
as big as we could get it in that small paper. You see, it was as prominent of space as could possibly be given, and I was
thought, well,
let's just put a rule on it, and we'll look at it.
But if I were to read this, I'd say revision of bylaws postponed, well, then I wouldn't know what's coming up or not.
Well, go ahead and read the damn prayer. It's supposed to be in September, you know.
Well, how many would have read them to have them 2 months?
I would.
I know, but then where that big one, they would be denied from all the private universities. They would be 25 that wouldn't even unfold the papers.
We'll call the lawyer in the morning. Y'all come to the meeting Thursday, we'll call the lawyer, and we have a good 2 programs, if you, even if you don't vote on them.
Another meeting Thursday.
And a board meeting is 7:30. If you approve these, if you don't, why it'll be deferred.
Second,
all in favor of adjourning, good night.